You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of our country's diversity. India's culture is rooted in colorful traditions that dates back to ancient history. Devasana Purnima is one among these traditions, which is observed just 15 days prior to world-famous Rath Yatra or Chariot Festival. It is believed just a vision of Lord on this day washes away all the sins. Though every year lakhs of pilgrims gather at Puri to witness this occasion, but this time amid the pandemic, it remained a low-key affair with no devotees around. Have a look.
Odisha God soaked in the air of mysticism as its Puri city observed the most sacred festival of Lord Jagannath's Snan Yatra or Dev Snan Purnima. Observed on full moon day in the month of Jyesht, the ritual is celebrated prior to the world-renowned Rath Yatra of the Jagannath Temple. Though this bathing festival is the only time in a year that non-Hindus as well as foreigners get the opportunity to see the idols of Lord Jagannath, Devi Subhadra and Lord Balbhadra, but this time there were no devotees around amid COVID-19 restrictions imposed to avoid gathering of people.
Ye Prabhu bahar aaya hai, lagta hai is saal corona ko खत्म करके ही जाएंगे, फिर रथ यात्रा होगा, ये होगा, प्रभु का निला में जो समर्पित हो जाएगा उसको कोरोना फोरोना कुछ नहीं होगा।
On the holy day of Dev Snan Purnima, the idols are escorted out of the Ratna Singhasan from the Sanctum Sanctorum of the Puri Jagannath Temple and are brought to Snan Bedi early in the morning. Then the procession called Pahandi is observed, in which deities are bathed with 108 pitchers of herbal and aromatic water that was taken from the well present inside the Jagannath temple. After bathing, the deities are dressed up in Gajanan Vesh. This time the ceremony was observed amid strict security and only those temple workers who had completed their vaccination course were allowed to bathe the idols. After this ritual, the deities are traditionally believed to fall ill due to heavy bathing.
स्नान करने के बाद भगवान को बुखार होगा, तो अभी अभी जगन्नाथ जी का शरीर अभी गर्म हो गया, अभी तब उनको अभी 15 दिन तक भगवान को अशुक रहेगा, उनका देखभाल हम लोग करेंगे, उसका भाई हम लोग हैं, उनको देखभाल करेंगे, उसका औषध भी दिया जाएगा, यहाँ कविराज है, उनका औषध भी दिया जाएगा, उनका औषध देने के बाद जगन्नाथ जी का तबीयत ठीक से रहेगा, फिर 9 तारीख को दरवाज़ा खोलेंगे, खोलने के बाद अभी उभा अमावस्या है, दो दिन रहेगा, 12 तारीख को भगवान रथ कावर में जाएगा।
As per the Skand Puran, Raja Indrayoma set this bathing ceremony when he installed the wooden deities in the temple. Solely being the celebration of Lord Jagannath, today the occasion of Dev Snan Purnima is accepted to be one of the most seasoned celebrations, highlighting the age-old traditions of India.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the dargahs of Sufi saints. So today we take you to Dargah of Hazrat Syed Hussain Shah Wali in Hyderabad city of Telangana that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities.
An epicenter of faiths, a place where brotherhood and bonhomie among various religions flourished and prospered at its best. The Dargah of Sayyid Hussain Shah Wali, situated in Hyderabad city, is one such melange of diversities. Whether one is Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, or from any other community, the aroma of the shrine serenades them into cheerfulness and a belief of fulfillment ensues in them.
बुजुर्गाने दिन का दर ऐसा है यहाँ पे कोई मजहब की ये नहीं है ना कोई हिंदू बोल के आता ना कोई मुसलमान बोल के आता जो भी आता अपनी जरूरत के लिए आता दुआ कर लेके चले आता फ़र्क इतना ही है मैं जब से होश संभाला जब से देखता हूँ ये एक ही दरगाह बोल के नहीं जितने भी दरगाह में गए वहाँ पे कोई भी मजहब का ऐसा नहीं है कि हिंदू आना मुसलमान आना कोई रोक टोक नहीं है
Popular among all faiths, the shrine holds an illustrative history that is around 455 years old. It is said that Hussein Shah Wali was a renowned architect besides being a Sufi saint. He is credited with building the Hussein Sagar, an age-old lake in Hyderabad. Believed to be a descendant of Khwaja Banda Nawaz and husband of Princess Khairiyat Un Nisa Begum, Hussein Shah Wali died in the year 1620.
వాతావరణం అంటే మంచిగానే ఉంది ఇంపోర్ట్ ఏదైనా అంటే మొక్కుకుంటే అది జరుగుతుంది ఇది నేను రావడం సెకండ్ టైం వచ్చాను ఇక్కడికి రావడం టెంపుల్కి జరిగింది కాబట్టి ఆల్రెడీ ఒక ఇన్సిడెంట్ జరిగింది కాబట్టి సో మళ్ళీ మొక్కుకుందామని వచ్చాను ఇక్కడికి హిందూ ముస్లిమ్స్ ఆల్ అంటే ప్రతి వాళ్ళు వస్తారు ప్రతి అంటే క్రిస్టియన్స్ కానీ హిందూస్ కానీ ముస్లిమ్స్ కానీ అందరూ వచ్చి ఇక్కడ దర్శనం చేసుకుంటారు దర్శనం చేసుకుని మంచిగా అనిపిస్తుంది కాబట్టి అందరూ వస్తున్నారు ఈ టెంపుల్కి హిందువులు రావాలి ముస్లిమ్స్ రావాలి డివైడ్ ఏం లేదు కదా అందరూ రావడానికి దర్శనం చేసుకోవడానికి ఉంది ఇక్కడ మంచిగా లోపల అబ్జెక్షన్ కూడా లేదు
The Dargah of Hussein Shah Wali is a perfect example of communal harmony that is witnessed throughout the length and breadth of our country. The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark of India's unity since time immemorial.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
The British-era narrow-gauge toy train in India's northern hill town of Shimla is once again welcoming crowds of tourists as states have started to lift restrictions after months of coronavirus lockdown. Famed for its panoramic views as it climbs more than 4,000 feet through heritage tunnels and along multi-arch bridges, the narrow-gauge 96-kilometer Kalka to Shimla route is a UNESCO World Heritage Site.
बहुत अच्छा रिस्पांस मिल रहा है इस समय हमारी ऑलमोस्ट कुछ गाड़ी में तो हमारी काफ़ी 90% बुकिंग भी हो चुकी है और ऑक्यूपेंसी अगर बात करें तो ऑन एंड एवरेज जो हमारी सभी गाड़ियों को मिला के हमारा 65-70% जो हमारा जो बुकिंग हो चुकी है और ऑक्यूपेंसी रह रही है मुझे लगता है कि आने वाले टाइम में हमारा जो ये बुकिंग जो हमारा बुकिंग है पैसेंजर्स की शिमला की तरफ जो है वो काफ़ी अच्छा रहेगा क्योंकि इसमें सभी लोग सभी स्टेट्स ने जो हमें अनलॉक की प्रक्रिया शुरू कर दी है
The line, known affectionately as the Toy Train Line, was opened in 1903 to connect Shimla, the summer capital under British colonial rule, to the northern Indian plains. Eighth month of pregnancy and an overburdened rural healthcare system are no hindrance to the medical officer and expectant mother, Dr. Shalini Sharma, who is balancing her duty with her first child on the way. 30-year-old Sharma joined the Rural Community Health Centre earlier this year in Lakhanpur village of Kathua district that receives a footfall from neighbouring villages as well.
हम patient को ignore नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि जब हम डॉक्टर की लाइन में ज्वाइन करते हैं तो तब से हम सोच के ये ज्वाइन करते हैं कि हमने लोगों की सेवा करनी है और फिर वही चीज़ मुझे मोटिवेट करती है लोगों जब देखती हूँ उनको दर्द में तो मुझे अपना वो कुछ याद नहीं आता अपना दर्द याद नहीं रहता
Although healthcare authorities have kept Dr. Shivani on non-COVID duties, she counsels patients who are scared of having symptoms similar to COVID-19, although they came out negative when they got tested. An Indian engineering student and fitness enthusiast Thulasinathan Ajanta recently attempted a world record for most knuckle push-ups in an hour. Ajanta, who hails from southern Chennai city, was trying to raise awareness about the importance of health and fitness after losing a friend to lifestyle-related disease. He did 1,638 knuckle push-ups in an hour in his first attempt but could not break the world record.
I have done 1,638 push-ups in my first official Guinness World Record attempt using knuckles. Actually, the Guinness World Record was 2,175. My target is to break 2,400. This is my first official attempt. I can make it at my next attempt.
The current record for the most push-ups in an hour is held by Pakistani man in 2016 with 2,175 push-ups.
The COVID-19 pandemic has turned the entire world into a big family. Several instances of noble deeds done by individuals and organizations could be spotted in every nook and corner of the country. A similar example was recently seen in Coimbatore city of Tamil Nadu, where people from an independent organization came forward to perform the last rites of individuals regardless of their caste or religion.
COVID-19 has posed several challenges before the country, among which performing the last rites of the patients who succumb to the disease is a major one. In many cases, the family of a deceased is in quarantine itself, while in few, the family may not be willing to accept the body of the patient as the contamination levels are too high and there are even chances of fatal infections if not handled with care. In such a situation, Samaritans across Indian cities have taken upon themselves to carry out the funeral ceremonies of COVID-19 patients whose bodies are refused by their families for their last rites. Few among them are the volunteers of a Coimbatore-based organization named Tamil Nadu Muslim Munithera Kazagam who cremate the bodies of COVID-19 patients.
இப்போ இங்கே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இந்த கொரோனா பாடி வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இப்போ இருக்கிற கால சுச்சுவேஷனில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா எந்த சொந்த பந்தமும் யாரும் வர்றதில்லை, யாரும் வர முடியாத சூழ்நிலை இருக்குது. அப்படிப்பட்டவங்களை வந்துட்டு நாங்கள் வந்து இங்கே வந்து அடக்கம் பண்ணுவோம். எங்கள் டீமில் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு 7 டீம் வந்து நாங்கள் வச்சுருக்கோம். ABCDF வரைக்கும் ஒரு 7 டீம் வச்சுருக்கிறோம். எங்களுக்கு வந்து மாவட்ட நிர்வாகி வந்து அந்த பாடி வந்து வந்ததுன்னா எங்களை கூப்பிட்டு சொல்லுவாங்க. நாங்கள் வந்து எந்த கபஸ்தானோ அந்த கபஸ்தானில் வந்து முறைப்படி நாங்கள் வந்து தொழுகை வச்சு அடக்கம் பண்ணுவோம். அது மட்டும் இல்லை, ஜாதி மடம் கடந்து வந்து எல்லா இது வந்து கிறிஸ்துவராகட்டும் இந்துவராகட்டும் அந்த எரிவுட்டுறதும் சரி, கிறிஸ்துவர் பெரியா வந்து கல்லறையில் வந்து சமாதி வைக்கிறதும் தமிழ்நாடு முஸ்லீம் முன்னேற்ற சார்பாக வந்து நாங்கள் வந்து இது ஒரு சேவையை வந்து பண்ணிகிட்ருக்குறோம்.
Till now, members of the TNMK have cremated over 350 bodies as per the religious rituals of the deceased. During the second wave of the pandemic, members of this NGO alone cremated around 120 bodies of COVID-19 patients. The organization performs cremation of all the dead bodies free of cost.
நாங்கள் இது வரைக்கும் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா கோயம்புத்தூரில் இந்த ஒரு மாதமாக பார்த்தீங்கன்னா கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒரு 126 பாடி பக்கம் வந்து நாங்கள் இந்த செகண்ட் அலையில் வந்து பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். 126 டோட்டலாக வந்து நாங்கள் வந்து பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். இந்த பகுதியில் மட்டும் நாங்கள் வந்து பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். அதாவது எல்லா மத இது படி அதாவது ஆத்துப்பாலமும் சரி, இந்த மயிலுக்கல் அங்கரகணம் எல்லாமே சேர்த்து தான் சொல்கிறேன். கோயம்புத்தூருக்குள்ளே வந்து நாங்கள் வந்து பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். டோட்டலாக வந்து ஒரு 350 பாடி பக்கம் வந்து நாங்கள் இது வரைக்கும் இந்த கோயம்புத்தூரில் மட்டும் நாங்கள் வந்து எங்கள் டீமை வச்சு பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். எங்களுக்கு வந்து 7 பேருக்கு வந்து டீம் இருக்குது. அதாவது ஒரு குழு ஒரு 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 டீமில் வந்து 7 பேர் இருக்காங்க. அதேமாதிரி 7 பேருக்கு ஒன்று குழு இருக்குது. ஏபிசிங்கிற குரூப் இருக்குது. லைன் படி வந்து எங்கள் குரூப்புக்கு சொல்லுவாங்க. இப்போ நான் வந்து பி டீமுடைய அமீர், எனக்கு வந்து சொல்லிடுவாங்க இந்த பி டீம் அமீருக்கு வந்து இந்த கபஸ்தானில் இந்த மவுத் இருக்குது, போய் அந்த மவுத்தை ஃபாலோ பண்ணுன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. நான் ஃபாலோ பண்ணி நான் அடக்கம் பண்ணி கொடுத்துட்டு தான் வெளியேறணும். அது மாதிரி தான் ஒவ்வொரு டீமுக்கும் வந்து வச்சுருக்கிறாங்க.
Rising above religious biases and working with only motive to serve the humanity, this is what these volunteers have been doing. Their work is inspiration for everyone to come forward and help the country at this time of need.
And now we will take you to Mumbai city of Maharashtra, where India's first transgender school has been opened in Vasai area to integrate a third gender into mainstream. Have a look.
In a first of its kind initiative, a new transgender school has been opened in Vasai East area of Mumbai. The initiative has been undertaken with a motive to empower the community and make them self-reliant.
मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा खुशी है कि ये किन्नर विद्यालय हमारे लिए खुला है क्योंकि ये बहुत ही आश्चर्यजनक चीज़ हुई हमारे समाज में मतलब पहली बार इतिहास में ये जो सुनाई में आया कि किन्नर विद्यालय जो कि पॉसिबल नहीं था लेकिन आज सुन के और इस जगह पे साथ में काम करके मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है.
Being called as the Kinnar Vidyalaya, this unique school is surrounded mostly by slums. Opened by the people of Mahashakti Trust, children from nearby slum areas as well as of the trans community attend this school and avail education. The trust is providing books to the students of Kinnar Vidyalaya and also plans for giving job placements to students. The school currently has 25 students.
पांचवी के बाद कैसा भी बचपन में हम लोग कैसा किन्नर थे तो कुछ ऐसे ऐसे हरकत रहती थी तो हम लोग को कोई भी छेड़ता था चिढ़ाता था तो उसके कारण हमको पढ़ने नहीं मिलता था तो हम लोग को इसको छोड़ना पड़ा मजबूरी के कारण. बहुत खुशी मिल रही कि हम लोग को फिर से मौका मिल रहा और हम लोग के हमारे किन्नर लोग के साथ में बैठ के मिल रहा तो और अच्छी बात हो रही है.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम प्रोवाइडिंग एजुकेशन टू ट्रांसजेंडर पीपल्स People of the Kinnar Vidyalaya are also encouraging more children from disadvantaged families to take admission in this school.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus.
Soybeans are a versatile food and one of the central ingredients of Japanese cuisine. They constitute the basis of many distinctive Japanese flavors such as soy sauce, miso and tofu and are processed into countless culinary products. This factory in Saitama north of Tokyo still uses the same traditional method for making soy sauce that was inherited 220 years ago by the Fuki family to preserve the flavor and quality of their soy sauce through special fermentation process.
お醤油の原料は伝統的な醸造方法では3つです。まず1つは大豆で、2つ目が小麦で、3つ目がお塩になってます。不液醤油は江戸時代から変わらない伝統的な醸造方法を守って、でもろみを昔からずっと使い続けている木の桶で約2年、発酵熟成させてそれを絞ったものをお醤油に。
The complex biological interaction between the ingredients during fermentation needs to be managed carefully and at the right time to get the perfect rich flavor. It starts from steaming soybeans to decomposing wheat in a mold called koji, to heating roast soy sauce in the tank before being filled in bottles. Soy sauce appeared in East Asian cuisine more than 2000 years ago. Now, it is considered as an important ingredient in Japanese dishes. Some of the typical types of soy sauce are regular all-purpose soy sauces like sashimi soy sauce with lighter flavor and color. And there is even low-sodium soy sauce for the more health-conscious. Young and emerging artists took to the streets of Ard Bouda village in Kabylie region in Algeria to perform in a festival marking World Music Day, celebrating Amazigh culture. Playing in different neighborhoods, young musicians from across the region got the chance to showcase their talent and perform to a huge audience, an opportunity they hardly get.
ان شاء الله ثم غريب يا ها وانت عجبه تعجبك اذا غاشيه خدمت كنا ميزانوك زغاشيت ميزانات تفعون هات سينوك الحوايج كي قدرنا هذه السنين تعدي فقي هذه السنين ان شاء الله كونوك وانت عجب شوفوا كي دير روحك سي فرانيين وانت عجبت الدفنا زغاشينا اعطيكم صحه.
With women wearing traditional dresses and all parts of the society singing and dancing, The festival is also a way of introducing younger generations to their musical heritage and traditions. This is the first edition of the festival organized by local residents who are hoping to turn it into an international music festival one day. Soba and udon are traditional Japanese noodle dishes that are very popular in Japan, but their flavor isn't complete without some shichimi on top of it. It is a multi-use chili mix seasoning which makes food delicious by enhancing its flavor. It is also used with pickled vegetables, miso soup and grilled meat and fish. The word shichimi means seven spices, although the main component of the mix is hot pepper. The story of shichimi started almost 400 years ago in this shop in Tokyo, where shichimi spices mixture were invented by a Japanese merchant in the year 1625 to be used as a medicine that stimulates blood circulation to recover quickly after illness. But within few years of its production, it turned into a popular spice. It is now produced by many companies, and the original shop still keeps all tools that were used when shichimi vendors moved between city and town to grind and sell the mixture.
その時代は将軍、徳川の将軍がいたんですけれども、三代将軍の家光の頃にですね、菊の御縁のご、あの菊の御縁の見切りというものがありまして、そちらの方で、献上したところ、ことのほか気に入っていただきて、あの山徳という、今うちでいうと野源堀の上についている山徳の称号をいただきました。7種類を申し上げますと、黒ごま、みかんの皮、唐辛子が2種類入っておりまして、焼きの時間を長くした焼き粉、で唐辛子、本来のものでやあの赤子、そして山椒、消しの実、朝の実と、この7種類で、構成されております。
Customers can buy the mixture in the same traditional package and also choose between three levels of chili strength in it. With the increasing popularity of Japanese food around the world, the demand for Japanese spices like shichimi, which is indispensable for obtaining the original Japanese flavor, has become very popular as well.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.